So today I thought that I would do a new moon Reiki video, just kind of help set some intentions for those new beginnings and kind of like a release of anything that isn't serving us right now, and a chance to kind of start over with something new. I do have a few crystals today. We're going to start off with a smoke cleanse with some Palo Santo. We're going to light our intention candle. And then maybe if there's time, I might pull a goddess oracle card or two, depending on if we have time or not. So let's do a smoke cleanse first. We'll light our intention candle and set our intention for the evening, hopefully one of release. And then we will start with some crystals and Reiki. So I just got a piece of Palo Santo here, and I'm just gonna kinda do a gentle smoke cleanse of anything that we're still kind of holding on to from today. Any weird or any energy that doesn't serve us. So this is a Pisces new moon, and Pisces is a mutable water sign. Very, very heavy on the emotional and like feeling aspect of ourselves. So if you have Pisces in your chart, this is going to be a particularly, I could say that word, particularly big time for you. Okay, so now that we've cleansed, I'm going to light our intention candle, and you can give whatever intention you'd like to this session. But of course, we've got our amethyst and herbs in there that are going to be good for kind of like stress relief and letting go. And of course, you can use that as a kind of a new chapter intention. The intention that I'm going to set tonight is so that it can be a beacon of healing and a tunnel of healing Reiki energy out to you guys. But you can go ahead and set whatever intention you'd like with this flame. And if you're feeling anxious or anything at all during this session, just go ahead and think back to our original intention. And maybe that'll help you kind of release some stress and anxiety. And, you know, look forward to our healing and our new energy for the Pisces new moon. And I'm gonna leave that over here while we do our session. I am also, forgot to mention, I'm also drinking some really, really yummy new moon tea, and I will put the shop that I got it from in the description box below in case you guys wanna try some. It's a little sampler and it's delicious. She also has a full moon tea, in case you're curious. So it's got some really yummy herbs just to kind of get me into the vibe of healing you. Now that that's all said and done, I'm going to go in with my selenite wands, and we're going to cleanse and kind of brush your aura and get you prepared for the general healing that will be coming. This is an aura selenite, so it's one of my favorites to kind of use to cleanse your aura, no pun intended. And the other piece is a nice piece of regular selenite. So I like to use them in conjunction to kind of help clear the way for some good healing. I hope it is what we accomplished tonight. It's been a rough couple of days in our house. My daughter is not feeling well. She's currently asleep, hopefully on the path to healing. But she is having a hard time. So hopefully she starts feeling better soon here in a couple days. And I hope so too, because I have to get back to work. So, but I just can't leave her. I can't leave her at home when all she wants is her mommy. Especially at nighttime when she's trying to sleep. So, I feel bad that I'm not there. Okay, take a deep breath in. Deep breath in and out. We're going to do a little bit of cord cutting, I think, with the regular selenite here. Think about something that you'd like to let go of. Hand it to me and I will take it. Hopefully take it out and away. Yeah, I think now we're all set for some Reiki healing to be pushed through, because it seems like all the energies that aren't serving us have been cleansed away. So now, I thought we would start off with amethyst. Amethyst is good for Pisces season. Really good for your third eye or your crown even. People kind of use them interchangeably. I have this really beautiful banded amethyst that I'll be using tonight. Hopefully you can see that. I think so. Maybe, yeah. There it is. It's this really beautiful banded amethyst tower. And so I'll be using that to draw the Reiki symbols on your third eye. And I'll be pushing that in with some nice Reiki as we get into the healing. If no one has told you, Reiki is a lot of work. So if at all during a session you feel as if you need water, you probably do. Keep an open mind to allow the channel of Reiki to come to you, to heal you. And if you're called to, you can always comment what your new moon manifestation might be for this new moon. I believe it's the snow moon. I could be wrong. Feel free to put your manifestation out there, because the more that you manifest and put it out into the open, the more likely it is to come true. We still might have some negative thoughts hanging around in our third eye, some disbelief, and that sort of thing will not help us in our manifestation process. If you have self-doubt, that manifestation will not come to you, my friend. It will not come. You have to believe in yourself as much as you believe in what you're manifesting. Believe that you are that master manifester. Otherwise, you're just talking to yourself at that point. Which, nothing wrong with that, but... we're not really getting to that root of that manifestation. You have to believe and trust your gut and your intuition and your third eye in order to believe that this stuff is really going to come to you. That's it for the amethyst. Another stone that I have that I thought would be good for Pisces season, because it's blue. So I have this nice symbol right here. Another tower. And I think it would serve us really well. Technically I use this for the throat chakra, which definitely help you in Pisces season as well. I feel like Pisces tend to be very emotional people, but they don't always say what's on their mind, what's in their heart. So this will help you kind of open up that clear communication channel, both with yourself and with people who need to hear it. So always remember to speak your truth. Your words are valid. Your thoughts are valid. Just because you think somebody doesn't want to hear it does not mean it does not need to be heard. Lately, I've been called to give more Reiki herbs, which I think are really helpful in this situation. Pulling out those thoughts of, I can't say what I need to say, because I'll be judged. Or I can't be the person that I am. I can't be me. Always be you. If you're too much for somebody else, find somebody that you're just enough for. Getting a message that you guys are having some sleep disturbances, or some of you out there may be having sleep disturbances, and I don't know how that relates to your throat chakra, but I feel like it may be because you're kind of over, you're ruminating on things that you haven't said. Or things that maybe you did say that you feel like you should regret, but those things needed to be said. Getting that message needed to be said. that chakra. One last stone that I have is actually a combination of a bunch of stones, and I actually just got this in my Goddess Provision box, and I love it. I'll link Goddess Provision stuff in the description box as well. But this is an aragonite, so it's a combination of clear quartz, amethyst, and rose quartz, and it's got some, it's got like a little self-healing potion thing on one side, and kind of the chicory symbol on the other, which I love. And the chicory is the symbol of power for Reiki. And so I feel like because it's February, it's not Valentine's Day anymore, but because it's February, I feel like it's important that we still do self-care and self-love. And I feel like this little thing is perfect for that. So we'll be doing some of that. Maybe there's some heavy heart energy out there as well. So these are good crystals for the heart chakra as well. So we can always send some Reiki energy there as well. And I want everybody to remember that self-care is not selfish. You cannot pour from an empty cup. What you give out is a reflection of what you have left. And if you have nothing left, you can't give anything. So just remember that. And always remember that you're a divine being of love. You can give and receive love in any way that works for you, or that your heart is made happy by. And you deserve love yourself. You deserve to be loved as you should be loved. Lightness now in that heart chakra. So I hope you do know that you are loved and you are deserving of love, and you are most importantly deserving of self-love. Do not forget that. Okay, so we are going to do some of the goddess oracle cards. They're absolutely lovely. I have missed them. They've been in a storage box somewhere. But I finally got them back. And I'm going to draw a couple. And whichever one resonates most for you, I would take that message. If it doesn't resonate now, always remember that it could resonate later. Okay, I'm gonna choose this one for the first one. Okay, so this is Morrigan, which is death and magic. See, beautiful cards. And I had this one the other day, and it had a very powerful message, much like the new moon message, so props to spirit for making it all come together. So it says, magic is everywhere and in all aspects of life, including death, dying, and decay, and what is dark and hidden deep within our very natures. Yet in modern culture, we spend so much time in denial, concocting ways to avoid death, refusing to allow nature to be true. We lost so much wisdom as a result. You are being invited to address the areas in your life that no longer serve and that need to die without a promise of what will take its place. Do you need to walk away from someone, a way of behaving or thinking? Like a caterpillar who has no idea how to be a butterfly, you must surrender to the process of metamorphosis. You must make room for the miracle while at the same time not demanding certainty. The magical death goddess Morrigan offers you an alignment task of self-inquiry. What death are you resisting right now? What darkness do you need to bring to awareness? How has fear ruled your choices? Who could you be if you had the courage to look at life on life's terms? Your magic is so much stronger than you think. You can do this. Your dreams depend on it. Morrigan will be with you every step of the way. So, much like with the new moon, new beginnings, new moon, what needs to die in order for something else to take its place, something beautiful, something miraculous. So that's the first one. The second one. Is this guy? Well, or girl, they're all novices. This is appropriate considering. This is Bridget, Creative Spark. So, let me see what Bridget has to say. And that's the first time I've gotten that one. I think she's beautiful. So it says, sometimes you get into a creative slump and you feel frozen in midair, unable to move in any direction. Perhaps you're unsure of the next step with someone new, or a project becomes a looming behemoth in your mind, or you can't think of anything to say in a social moment. Maybe you think all your best ideas are gone. Bridget offers you the alignment task of moving your attention away and remembering what it was like when you were little, when your finger painted and drew stick figures and played with your pals in the sandbox on the playground. What moved you and lit you up then is the same creative spark that can move you now. Playful curiosity is what is called for. Don't take yourself or your current situations too seriously. It's time to be free from the burden of expectation you've set upon yourself. Don't try so hard. The triple goddess of hearth, the forge, and inspiration brings all of her aspects together to help you sparkle. So I think that's beautiful. We'll do one more. And like I said, all of these could apply, or just one of these could apply, so just kind of keep that in mind as well. And then we have Isis, rebirth. Terribly appropriate for the new moon. Let's see, she says, let me find her. There she is. It says, the goddess Isis, with her powers of reincarnation, has a message for you. You are not broken. You are not wounded beyond healing, and opportunities are not necessarily lost forever. Your insistence on defining yourself by your losses and wound stories are not serving you now. Your alignment task is to fully accept things as they are. Choose to find a way to put the pieces back together. Let die what doesn't serve you, again, and focus on what works. There is so much goodness to come from this situation, even if in this moment you feel trapped. The goddess Isis wants only the best for you. As your fierce ally, she will challenge you when you go off track. So pick up the pieces, tell a new story, and find home again. You'll be amazed at how beautifully things come together when you reject the trap created by the stories you tell yourself. You have the key. Use it. So I think those were all beautiful messages for the new moon in Pisces. And I hope you guys were able to get a feeling of healing and completeness and wholeness from this Reiki session. If you guys have any suggestions or any ideas for the next video, please feel free to let me know. I'm more than willing to take them into consideration. And I hope you have a wonderful, blessed, beautiful night.